In other news, detained former Senator Laila De Lima again reaching out to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Malacanang earlier said Marcos cannot directly intervene in her drug case and order her release. But in a tweet, De Lima pointed out that what the chief executive can do is to order the Justice Department to stop blocking the testimony of a witness trying to recant his allegations against her. Former National Bureau of Investigation and Corrections Officer Rafael Ragos has said he was only coerced to implicate De Lima in the illegal drug trade inside the National Penitentiary by then-Justice Secretary Vitaliano Aguirre. Ragos, though, has yet to formally testify in court. De Lima is now calling on Marcos to reverse what she described as grievous wrongs inflicted by his predecessor. The staunch critic of the Duterte administration has been detained since 2017. Meanwhile, U.S. Senator Edward Markey and other American lawmakers again urged the government to drop all charges against De Lima. This comes just days after the former senator was held hostage by a fellow detainee who was trying to escape their detention center. Markey was part of the U.S. congressional delegation who visited De Lima in her cell back in August.
The Philippines has yet to detect the new Omicron variant XBB that is driving up COVID cases in Singapore. Philippine health officials vow to continuously conduct surveillance to monitor the subvariant's possible entry. Preliminary studies suggest the XBB sublineage shows higher immune evasion ability than the BA.5 variant. The World Health Organization says there are now more than 300 sublineages of Omicron, which is the dominant variant of concern worldwide.
Director General has been very clear that this is not over and that there is much more work that we need to do.
Okay.
The Philippines on Thursday logged over 2,800 new COVID cases, the highest daily tally since October 1st. More than 1,100 infections are in Metro Manila. 40 additional deaths were also reported. Active cases are at 25,293.
The son of Philippine Justice Secretary Boying Remulla arrested during an anti-illegal drug operation. Juanito Remulla III was caught carrying nearly a kilo of high-grade marijuana worth around 1.3 million pesos or about $65,000. The 38-year-old Remulla was arrested in Las Piñas City when he took delivery of the package containing the drugs, which was sent from abroad last October 11th. His father, the DOJ secretary, vows not to interfere in the case. He says his son must face the consequences of his actions. He thanks the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency for doing its job without fear or favor, and he wishes his son a path to redemption. Secretary Remulla returned to Manila Thursday afternoon after attending the 51st session of the United Nations Human Rights Council in Geneva, where he talked about the Marcos administration's recalibrated drug war program. A call for Remulla to resign from his post is now trending on Twitter in the Philippines following the arrest of his son.
Other political members of the Remulla family speaking out on the arrest of the Justice Secretary's son. Cavite Governor John Vic Remulla, who first confirmed the news about his nephew's arrest, vowed to stay away from the case and not to use his position to influence the outcome. Meanwhile, Gilbert Remulla, the director of the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation, took to Twitter to say the situation is a cross that his family will bear. He also described drug addiction as a scourge that ruins lives and tears families apart. Juanito Remulla III underwent inquest proceedings in Las Piñas early Thursday for drug charges and is currently in the custody of anti-narcotics agents.